Amy Jacobson on AM 560, The Answer.
Is he a hero or an enabler? Good Monday morning. Amy Jacobson here. John Anthony in for Dan Proft.
Hey.
So good to have you in. Thanks for coming in today.
Glad to be in.
Especially after a long night watching football.
I feel like we're back at COVID.
Okay.
This is the last time we did this.
I know. We're in two separate locations, but we're always together.
That's right.
So I don't know if you heard last week, there is a man, he's a Chicagoan. I think he's from Edison Park, Chris Amatore, and he is a property owner. He has a lot of buildings on the south side, and he decided, you know what? I'm going to open up my vacant buildings, my abandoned buildings, to migrants.
I saw 5-year-olds with no jackets on the streets. You know, I was taking my jacket off, putting it on them, and I'm like, tomorrow's going to be negative 14. I'm like, what's going on? I just decided, hey, I got the heat on, I got gas, I got electric, water. I go, let's fill them and we'll worry about the details later.
And so many people called in. We talked about it for a half hour that, you know, he's a good Samaritan. Other people said, no, he's an enabler. So with that, we tracked him down via some of our listeners. And we're so pleased to have on our program this morning, Chris Amatore. Good morning, Chris. How are you?
Good. How you doing? Could you hear me okay?
Yeah, we can hear you just fine. So I have the number one question that I wanted to ask and other people, are you receiving any government subsidies for the people that you're housing?
No, I'm not.
Really? Okay. And how many people are you housing and in how many different buildings? Because I know we talked on, I think, late Friday, and you said you're going to be opening up some other properties that are vacant right now.
Yeah, right now I'm housing 448 migrants.
Okay, and what kind of building? Like, where are your buildings?
It's a total of 15 buildings. Two on the two that were in the news are in like the South Chicago neighborhood, and then other ones like scattered on the south side of Chicago.
So how did you meet these people and then decide, you know what, I'm going to help out. I'm going to do God's work. You know, the Bible always teaches us to help those in need. What did you approach these people? Were they outside somewhere or what happened?
Well, you know, me and my wife, you know, we run a God-fearing family, and we decided to, every weekend, that's something we do is we go out and try to help people. And we do random stuff. Sometimes it's just picking up garbage. Other times it's helping the homeless. And that day I was reading in the news that there was people eating out of garbage cans, didn't have jackets, coming off these buses and flip-flops at something called like the landing zone. I just got involved in this like 12 days ago or like 2 weeks ago. So I didn't really know anything about this, like the migrants or anything. That's all above my pay grade. And, so I went down there with my son and we were handed out some jackets to the people. And then I'm like, what's going on down here? And, I'm in property management. I've been housing the homeless for the last 19 years, but I've been paid for that though, you know? And so I contacted the mayor's office and I'm like, what's going on with these people? Like, and they're like, well, there's 550 people that we don't have room right now in the shelters. And I'm like, well, it's going to be negative 14. What the heck's the plan here? They're like, there is no plan. We just have these buses. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm like, and I said to them, I'm like, you know, I got like 600 units that are, I could house 600 potentially. And basically I just got no comment. So I just decided to do it. And now I'm here and, I am trying to work with the city to see if we could place them somewhere else. I talked to the aldermen, because I understand, you know, I'm like, I'm not trying to like ruin people's blocks or anything like that. I'm like, but I just thought it was the right thing to do, the thing that Jesus would do, the thing that, that I try to raise my kids to do and set an example, which I know it's a little extreme, but, you know, now I'm here.
So did you grab some people from the landing? Did you grab some people from the landing zone, a certain family? Did you vet any of these people or were they how did you get them keys to your buildings?
Yeah, so it started at the landing zone, and then I housed 54 at the property on Colfax, and then And then from there, and then after I talked to the mayor's office and stuff, I was like, okay. And then I went to this address where the main shelter is in Pilsen, 2241, and South Halsted is over there. And there you see all the people just outside the shelter trying to get in, but they're filled. And there's like, at first I thought it was all like, just like dudes and stuff, you know, but it's actually, you know, all these kids, like women and children. And I'm like, okay, you know, I see no difference. You know, we're all God's souls, right? And so I don't care what the reason they're here, whatever, but I see women and children on the street. Well, I'm alive. That's not tolerable in the city of Chicago. This is not a third world country, you know? And so if the mayor doesn't want to step up and do something, I decided to do something.
Yeah, Chris, this is John Anthony. Here's a question for you. You might not be getting paid now. Will there be an invoice sent to the city of Chicago at some point? Because, I mean, who's covering the utilities for these properties?
Well, yeah, John. Well, here's the thing. I've already spent $175,000 of my own money. I bought beds for everyone. I bought food. I'm paying heat, everything. I'm not charging any rent. I don't even have a full list of the names of the people that I have right now. Because I was just... Me, my mother, everyone have just been, we've been putting them in cars and housing them so they don't have to sleep and freeze to death on the street.
Right.
You know, so, and I'm figuring that out. And, but from everything that I see, these are really good people. These are family people, people that want to work. But that's just my opinion.
Right.
And, well, you know, from dealing with them firsthand, you know?
Yeah. Are they gracious? I mean, have they, you know, do they thank you for what you're doing?
Oh, my God. Yes. They are unbelievable. Like, there was a video I put out because the alderman of the 7th Ward, or I don't know, he has a lot of hate toward me for some reason, I believe, because he comes calling the police were coming by and everything. So, and like the neighbors, I could see were upset. So they decided they wanted to clean up the whole block to show them, you know, and I videoed it. And, you know, of course, people try to spin it like I'm putting them to work for free labor or something. I'm like, what are you talking about, you know?
Hey.
I'm like, they're just cleaning the block, you know.
Unintended
consequence. They're trying to show that they're... I'm sorry, what was that?
Unintended consequence, right?
Yeah, which I don't really care. I only got one person to impress in this life, and that's God.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, and here's another thing. I spent 175 G's. I'm doing all this. The only person that I should have hate from is my wife. You know what I mean? You know, I have no idea where all this hate comes from, all these people jumping to the conclusions. I'm like, leave me alone if you don't like it. I'm not asking for nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, yes, of course I would take money from the city. I'm not an idiot. I'm a businessman.
Right.
But I didn't do this for that reason. But the city should step up, and they should pay me, or
I'm
they should
sure
take
they
them. I'll help drive them to another location if they have it. You know?
Well, I'm sure they will.
What's the exit plan? I mean, some might not want to leave.
You know, it's like, you know, it's so weird that everything I go to these properties every day because, you know, I'm nervous. I know my insurance ain't going to cover it if it burns down or something, you know? So I'm going there every day to check and everything. They answer the door right away. They are so gracious, you know? Like, it's unbelievable how gracious, you know? They all call me Sam Crystal Ball when I get there, you know? Yeah. And they're so gracious. And because, one, imagine making that trip from Venezuela and all that stuff, but, you know, whether it's legal, illegal, whatever, that's above my pay grade. I'm a retired Chicago fireman, right? I only did 16 years, you know, but so, like, I don't have the answers. I don't know nothing, right? All I know is that what I believe in, you should help people when they're in need, and anything else is above my pay grade. You know
but
what I mean?
You're a businessman. You need to make money. So what's the exit plan?
Oh, he's going
to
get paid.
What happens if somebody commits a crime that is staying at one of your properties? Are you going to kick them out?
Hell yeah, I'm going to kick them out. Yeah, no, and that's the thing. Like, I understand there's, you know, laws, but I think, like, everyone kind of has an understanding right now that, you know, if you know, there's no drinking at my properties, there's no smoking weed, any of that. They're out of there. And guess what? They could call the cops on me because I will throw their ass out.
Yeah, but
without that, because they understand how this is, and they understand that no one is helping them, and I'm helping them with my own funds. They know, I mean, yeah. John, if I do get paid, great. I'll probably end up using that money to do more of this or something to help. But
hey, Chris.
You know, but right now, go ahead.
Listen, Chicago, Cook County has some of the best squatter rights tenants tenants, you should know this. You've been involved in Chicago real estate. Because initially,
I managed 5,000 units. I'm a professional management company. Right. I know exactly how all this works.
Right. Yes. Initially, the Colfax property was called out as a break-in, that they were breaking into the property. Now, how have some of the other neighbors taken up on your stance of allowing these illegal immigrants into these properties? Has there been any clashes with neighbors in all these 15 buildings where they're being housed?
Well, I mean, there hasn't been any physical clashes yet, fortunately, but I have received a lot of hate and a lot of, you know, threats. Like, for example, on the Colfax, you know, they're like, yo, you better get all these motherfuckers out of here. I'm going to shoot up your building, stuff like that. And I understand that. And, you know, I understand that there's a lot of hate. And that's why I have talked. First day, I went to Alderman Mitchell's place and I filled out a form. He wouldn't see me. And I said, hey, I'm letting you know what I'm doing in your ward. You got any ideas? You want to take them somewhere else? What do you want to, you know, or whatever, you know what I mean? But the only thing I was seeing is just getting them in some warmth and getting them some food.
Yeah. What are you doing for your own public safety? What are you doing for your own safety? I mean, you getting all these threats, you getting death threats, anything like that? What are you doing to protect yourself and your family? Because, I mean, you know, people in this day and age, they'll literally come after you and try to bring harm to you or your family. Are you protecting yourself?
To tell you the God's honest truth, I actually did hire an off-duty police officer to sit in front of my house for a week. It cost me like $1,800, but because I was out till 3 a.m. every day housing these people, and I was like getting these, you know, it was more of like in person and stuff, like even like little old ladies on the way to church, like pull their car up and like, excuse me, sir, and then they're like, like, oh, you're that guy from the news, right? I'm like, yeah, how can I help you, man? They're like, oh, you hate black people. I get it. You hate black people. I'm like, damn. And then she just, like, you know, cruises away. I'm like, oh, my goodness. I'm like, that seems like a really good person right there that is convinced that I'm a bad person for whatever reason. I'm like, what did I say on the news that was so bad that I believe in God and that I think I'm on God's plan and that the chips should fall the way? Because that's what I believe in. You know, I don't believe it's my decision to do that.
I admire what you're doing. I understand what you're doing. But what is the exit plan? Is there like they could stay for 60 days? They could stay for 90 days? Do you want 30 days? I mean, have you set boundaries and parameters with these people?
I told them I understand that they're just getting done with the craziest part of their lives ever, and they don't know what's going on, and it's insane. I said, in a month or so, we'll talk, and because I don't really know, you know, I'm expecting that maybe someone is going to help me with the city or someone is going to help me with the state. And it doesn't have to be paying me money. You know, if that's the way it pans out, great. You know, I mean, you know, because I see how the city's pissing away the money. So they might as well give it to someone that's going to use it good. But if not, so be it. Where do you want to take them? Let's take them somewhere. That's what I say. Like the city calls the building department on me and this and that. I'm like, all right, you want them out? Where are we taking them? I don't give a shit, you know?
Hey, Chris.
You know what I mean? Like,
Chris,
don't swear.
Chris, yeah, Chris.
I'm sorry about that.
Are you concerned about the liability should something happen in one of your properties with these illegal immigrants?
Of course I am.
And with your insurance not being able to cover? I mean, that comes straight after you, correct?
Yeah. So, yeah, it's gonna be another pretty penny I'm going to have to pay, you know, so hopefully I get this figured out, you know?
Oh, man.
All right.
You're a brave soul.
Yes, and who's feeding them on a daily basis? I mean, can some of them work, or can they work for your company or do anything to work for food?
Right now, I got it set up on Instacart, so I got all the properties on Instacart, and it automatically sends the same amount, like, every, like, 4 days. And I've really been doing this.
That's right off.
You know, this is all, like, I'm just, like, kind of getting this figured out as I go, But yeah, that's, you know, this is the truth, you know. Like, yeah, I guess you could say I'm just like an idiot that just jumped into this and didn't really have anything figured out, you know. So yeah. I guess that's a way to sum it up, you know.
Well, I'll tell you this: come tax time, this is a big loss. This is a big loss of income for you. So I'm sure you can find a way to offset this.
Yeah, you know, and I'll be all right. I'm not like this like guy who's like saying I'm going to donate. I'm giving away everything in my life.
I'm sure.
You know, I've had a lot of success in my life, and I'm doing this, and I'll be okay. You know what I mean? So.
All right. Well, Chris, thank you so much for sharing your story with us. And
yeah, thanks, Chris.
I mean, they are very gracious, as they should be, for what you're doing for them.